I better turn that off and get a strike, like I care. I don't monetize anything. Well, I've done my shopping now. I bought stuff at a couple of thrift stores, Wally World, went to a Goodwill. What else? I went to a department store. What did I get at? Oh, I went to a camera shop. Because I'm going to get me a new camera one of these damn days without buying me no damn GoPro. And some bitches don't zoom. I don't like nothing but don't zoom. I like to see way away. Hell, I can't see that shit. I bought me a thing here. Maybe it'll hold my... phone. I'd look at it to see what the hell it was. This game tonight and tomorrow night. OSU and no use playing today and tomorrow. I went to McDonald's at lunch, which was a no-no, because I had biscuit sausage. I should have just had the damn biscuit. I mean, the sausage without the damn biscuit. Oh, well. It's time to go. How did I put this one up? Went to that funeral yesterday. It was an all-day affair, let me tell you. I don't like funerals like that. I don't like all-day affairs. Just too much crap. But he had a nice funeral. His dog was there. Somebody brought a dog. Who does? I just tease him. I bought baby some little booties to wear when she gets this winter. Oreo won't wear them. He makes you carry him. And that's what she is. And so I ain't stepping in that damn school. He said, nope, I don't do outside. You know, he starts putting him down in the snow. He'll hold his feet up. Like, he ain't putting me in that shit. Crazy. I ain't had baby during the snow, so let's see how she acts. But I did buy her some booties. That'd be good if she walks on a black top or anything like that. Keep running her feet. I've been watching that ASP, whatever, about the world mistreated animals. I can't stop. My motto is, if you cannot afford an animal, or a kid per se, either one, then don't have it. Give it back. Give it away. Do something. If you can't afford it, don't have it. That's honest God truth. If you cannot afford it, I'm trying to start this up a little crooked. Hold up. Maybe that's straighter than it is. I'm going real slow through Guthrieite. This is the Guthrieite, so I'm getting bumps here, but I'm sorry about all the bumps here. Can't help these roads. They're sorry. They're not good. Maybe that'll help. I lean anyway. So maybe we'll lean together on the phone. There was everybody there. They had food and food. They've been bringing food in for 3 days. Oh, God, I told everyone I went. I said, man, you should see the food. And we're talking food now from good cooks. We ain't know that ready crap out of a box. Damn Amish people could cook good food. Every one of them's got a salt shaker bottom, I call it. You know, the weeble and the wobble, but they don't fall down, I'm telling you. What's that up here? Oh, I'm hot, tired. I bought me a hat. I bought this hat. Okay. I bought this hat. Wait a minute, I ain't done yet. And I bought this hat. Oh, hell, like you ain't got good sense, you quit buying shit. But I liked them. I bought a brown one and a black one and a white one. None of them went with my OU shirt, so I had to wear my OU shirt. Lord, Lord, what's all this? Well, right in the middle of Oklahoma and United States 77, which is a division. Turn up here on Noble, There's the library. Lots of bumps in. Here's they call the stables. They used to board, city people used to board their horses out here to call the stables, and that's a big fancy restaurant. They serve barbecue. Barbecue. A little different than that Texas barbecue. Oh, I'm a little tired. I'm going to go home. I don't want to go anywhere this weekend. It's one of them Memorial Day or Labor Day or something. And you don't want to go out to any park or anything. You have to fight for a space and all that crap. Oh, it ain't going to happen. Not going to happen. So I decided I'd wait till after the holidays. And then I'm out of here for a few days. I think I got an eye examiner coming up in September. I don't know what day. Maybe it's sometime in September. Around the 15th, I think. Or 13th or something. The baby puppies is supposed to be born the 17th of September. She goes that long. I think that'll make her 62 days. Between 69 days to have pups. I don't want to be on the road when she has the puppies. I guarantee you. Close to this damn bed up here in case it's a problem. Hell, I might just take a couple of days and have motor for a couple of days before she has the bugs. I don't know. They probably won't watch her at night, so they have nobody to get out here. Set up with her all that long like I would. But in case something happens, they have medical supplies that I don't have. So, okay. We'll figure it out. Yeah, I got some little booties. Got her some booties. Booties. Oh, God. Got little booties. See there, little booty. Put her little foot in it and Velcro around it. She's good to go. Just her size, too. I asked if they said a picture wall were at Minifield's and Dotson's. Should have bought Oreo some, but hell, he would wear them. And besides that, he's the type of dog you're not going to put him down to beat him down. He's, if it's hot concrete or pavement or something, he got better sense. He starts raising up his feet. Nope, I ain't going down there. If it's in the grass, he'll go. When I first got him, he was scared death of grass. He had never been on dirt. He was always on concrete. Came from a puppy mill to a humane society, which was concrete. And then he went to a penitentiary to be trained. It was concrete. So when I had him, I took him and put him in grass. And hell, I had a good time with him. He got to experience all the good things he'd been left without. Poor little Minnie Pen, she was dumped at a truck stop, running after trucks trying to get her a ride. She was I call her a little lot lizard. Somebody dumped her. Can you imagine dumping a little bitty, and she wasn't even a year old, at a damn truck stop, of all things, and dodging semi trucks, and she ain't no bigger than a damn little rabbit. She did a bitty thing. Hell, people could do that. These bumps, I'm sorry, pull over to make the long bridge. I'm supposed to be building us a new one. So, at least my phone ain't jumping out, going crazy. I had enough of that crap. Let me straighten it back up, though. There we go. I had to put a rubber band on it or something. I don't know what the hell was wrong with it. It went crazy on me. It's hot. It's miserable. It's 3:51 in the afternoon. Baby's been in the pen all day since about 1 o'clock, 12:30, 1 o'clock. I put her in the pen. She tears up. She loves to get into the trash. When she gets mad, she tears up all the paper and scatters it all over the house. Or you used to tear down the curtains only on the north side of the house since the side of the driveway's on. Look and see where I went. Now he don't do nothing. He just goes back to bed. He thought he'd be back. He was so scared nobody was coming back, I guess. So, but he knows I'm coming back. I've never left him at night nowhere. I know if it just starts getting dark, I'm coming home. What else did I buy? I don't buy much shit. Went to the grocery store, wise out. What else did I buy? Hell, I don't know. Well, I know I bought me a good Canon camera. It's got the real super zoom and all that other shit. Small. So there you go. To go with my other collection of cameras. Find one that suits me one of these damn days. I like that old film, you know. Now everything's on them damn little 8 megs, 16 megs, 32 megs, and all that crap. Digital. I remember when we used to take them old photographs and plan developed, and you had anticipation waiting for the film to be developed. You forgot what pictures you took, so, you know. Wow! And you bought the whole package. It wasn't like Walmart. You just choose the pictures you got the whole package. Whether they was messed up or not, you still got the whole roll of film where, you know, it didn't take or not, it didn't matter. So, that's the way life is. Brother was there, and I felt sorry for him. He couldn't see worth a snot. I tried to give him my glasses, and I guess they didn't fit his up. He left his at home or something. So he had his grandson read some of the passages. Read his last speech. He said, "You want to?" And I said, "No, I hand you my glasses." That's what he told me. I'm driving into the sun, so I don't know how that's going to work. At least I've got this thing turned towards me. Come on now, I'll hit you in the rump. I'm trying to clean my English up. Well, there's the Delisi gravel pit, sand pit. And then they got this, over here they got where they work on steel or something. They make steel something. Some of the oil field, they make steel something. Out of steel. Tubing, dehydrators, and all right, let's put it forward to the metal and let's get down the road. Around here, they either lay the tailgate down, or they ain't got no tailgates at all, or they got a string mesh thing across it to keep blocking the wind. So they know I clean out their truck when they go to town, and all the trash, nails, lumber blow out the back. It's these farmers around here, though. Well, I will let you go. I'll talk to you later. There's not much more to say, except I'm on my way home. And the road looks pretty good. It's nice and sunny. I'm begging to go to the lake, but they won't quite let me until I finished all my appointments. Then I'm out of here. Talk to you guys later. Have a great day.